Can make some more coffee? I'll make a new pot.
No.
Easy.
Thanks. Two's the limit.
Well, how about some toast? Because you didn't
Carrie,
eat any cinnamon
please
roll.
Stop trying to take care of me.
Dadgum, it's just breakfast. Big deal.
Well, it is a big... I'm sorry. I'm really sorry I'm acting this way. It's just... it's easier right now.
Which way are you acting?
I want to just block out the world.
A lot of people try to do that, but it really never works out. You know that song, People Need People?
Mm. You need them and care about them. And don't walk out on them.
Mm. Oh, thank goodness, somebody. You cannot believe the morning that I have had. I have a run in my stocking, and then I decide to do my nails for the first time. I declare, at least it's been 2 months. And what do? I break a nail trying to do it. See, that nail will probably never come back. Then I try to take a nail, and I was going to fix it with that little nail glue. Spill nail glue all over my new silk blouse that I bought specifically for this app. It's kind of updated because it makes me look like a pig. All this in a day that I'm supposed to count my blessings. I cannot believe it.
Tiffany, at least the worst is over with.
I certainly hope so. With my luck these last few days, if this is the worst that happens to me today, I will be eternally grateful.
You want some coffee?
No, honey, I don't
Anything?
Have time for coffee. I think I'll just take this.
No,
but I'll see you
at
Kelly's
coffee.
Tonight, right? No, no coffee for me, honey. I'll see you at Kelly's, though. But Sean's not going to get to come. He has to work. I cannot believe he works on a day that we're supposed to give thanks. What a day. I'll see you guys later. My hair's
well, try to lift it up a little bit, you know, Tiffany.
I know. Okay, have a good day.
Thank you. So will she?
Will she what?
Oh, come on. Will she see you at Ruby's? Jake will be there.
Terry, I'm so glad that Jake came back for Adam, but as far as I'm concerned, I really wish you weren't here.
I don't believe that for a second.
All we do is fight.
Well, he's been here a couple of days, right? Give it a chance.
We've both given it several chances.
Well, you didn't answer my question. Are you going to be there?
I don't want to go and be a bore. I don't want that for Ruby's sake.
Are you scared?
No!
Okay, will you be there?
Larry, could I have a moment of your time?
Of course.
I'd like to talk about this artifact of yours.
Well, there's nothing I enjoy talking about more.
Well, I'm interested in what you have up your sleeve. Of course, I think I know what it is, but...
Really?
There's nothing wrong with going for the big bucks. In fact, I'd be quite surprised if you didn't have some kind of a money-making scheme in mind.
Well, of course, everybody likes to make money.
I think the secret has to be about opening trade with China in a great big way, huh?
You sly old fox.
Didn't Tracy warn you never to take me for granted?
Something's on your mind, Ariel.
What is it? Well?
Ariel, what is it?
I was just thinking about Thanksgiving and how much I have to be grateful for.
Then why do you seem so troubled?
Because I'm afraid I'm going to sound terribly ungrateful. Do you remember our last holiday in the Caribbean?
Of course.
The weather was so balmy and we were so relaxed and happy and it was just the two of us. Wouldn't you love to go again?
Well, we will, certainly.
Well, let's fly down there. And we'll come back here when the Aphrodite's ready.
Something's happened to you. Since we came to Port Charles, I don't know, you've changed.
Of course not.
Oh, yes, you have. No. Oh, yes. I can't put my finger on it, but you're different.
I've just had more headaches, that's all.
Well, I was hoping Dr. Hardy could help you with that.
You know, I think it's the weather here on top of everything else. And I was going to talk to Dr. Hardy about it the next time I see him, which will probably be this afternoon. But that's another reason why getting away excites me so much. Doesn't it appeal to you at all?
Very much. But not now. I cannot leave Port Charles just yet.
Well, fine. Then you stay here and I will fly down.
No. You will not travel by yourself, let alone be there on your own.
Lawrence, the boat is almost finished, and you could take a leisurely trip down when it's ready, and I would be there waiting for you. What do you think? Lawrence?
I need you here with me.
We would be together.
Here. I need you here. I can't leave. I know you're disappointed, and I know that you're going to ask me why.
Not if you don't want me to,
I won't. Well, I think you're entitled to know. Although I'm rather ashamed to tell you. I'll leave out the ugly details, but, you see, I'm experiencing certain financial difficulties.
Oh, I had no idea.
Well, that's because I wanted to keep it from you.
But why? If there was anything I could do, I would want to do it.
There is nothing that you can do. I am the one who must do everything. I simply need you by my side. I need your support. If I don't do anything, I could lose my businesses, my estates in England, everything. You see, I'm being hounded for certain debts that I have incurred.
What are you going to do?
It involves Edward.
Are you going to borrow money
from
him?
No, I'm not going to borrow money. I visualize a joint venture of sorts. So you see, my darling, much as I would like to go along with your plan...
Shh, don't say another word. I wouldn't think of leaving you now, not even for a moment.
I hate to say no to you.
But you're not saying no to me. All you're saying is we'll postpone it, and that's exactly what we'll do.
You do that for me.
You've done far more for me than I'll ever be able to do for you.
It's not true.
I owe you my life.
I have to go.
Don't. Just stay here and we'll pretend like we're at home. Please.
Well? This is actually nice having Thanksgiving here. There's no cooking, no mess to clean up, no fuss.
Mm-hmm.
I have a lot to be thankful for. I'll have you home soon, I know.
Why'd you have to go?
Something I got to attend to.
There's nothing to do with what Robert's up to, is it?
No.
You mean that?
Hey, listen. I gave my word for all it's worth. I intend to keep it.
I just don't want you two going at each other again. I really... Please.
Hey, listen. I promise. Word of honor. You know, I'm not a saint. But that man, he can be pretty impossible sometimes.
I know. Yeah, I know. But just give him a chance.
Give him a chance. Okay. I'll give him a chance, I promise. I have to go.
Wait. You promise me one thing?
Anything?
You come back later.
You're trying to stop me?
Keep me going all day.
Monica. 10th floor, Georgia Price. How can I help you?
Good morning, Miss Price. This is Dimitra, Mr. Giron's friend.
Oh, yes. And a good morning to you.
Well, it would be if I could give Mr. Giron some good news about his daughter. How is Olivia?
Well, there's been no change. Miss St. John's still listed as critical.
Oh, dear. Oh, well. I wonder if you could do me a favor and call me the moment that she improves. I would like to know the moment she regains consciousness.
You mean notify Mr. Jerome?
Oh, no. I'm taking all his calls, you know. He's still recuperating. But I believe you have my personal number on record, do you?
Well, I'll speak to the doctors.
Thank you very much. I do appreciate it. Goodbye.
Goodbye. That was Mr. Jerome's companion, Dimitra.
Ah, oh, what did she want?
Well, she was just checking on his daughter's condition. And she requested that you call her the moment that Olivia St. John regains consciousness.
If she regains consciousness.
You don't think she will?
At this point, I really don't know what to think. I just hope that I can make that call. Off to work I go.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Dr. Quartermain. Since we missed having breakfast together, I thought maybe we could have lunch. And not in the cafeteria.
Would you be quiet?
Quiet? Sure, we could go someplace quiet. Possibly someplace romantic. And don't feel uneasy. This is just a luncheon. As for the usual excuses, Alan's not here today. And for once, Amy's not within earshot, so the entire establishment won't even know we've gone.
Okay, thank you very much for the invitation, but I'm sorry. I cannot accept. In fact, I cannot even leave the hospital.
Oh, I know. It's tough to go anyplace without a car.
Oh, that's right. Did you by any chance have anything to do with the flat tire in my car this morning?
Was there something wrong with the ride to work?
No, I'm not talking about
that. I enjoyed every minute of it. In fact, as I recall, you even relaxed enough to laugh about something along the way. So, since you're dependent upon the niceness of other drivers today, how about that lunch?
I'm sorry, but I have to talk to someone. Excuse me.
Not until you give me an answer.
I have to talk to Mr. Scorpio. Hello, Robert.
Thank you for seeing me, love.
Yes, do you want to talk in my office?
I don't think we've got the time for that.
Well, then how about here?
Thank you.
Sounded kind of urgent when you called this morning.
Yes. There's something I want to ask you to do for me.
Well, if I can, certainly. What?
I want you to help me catch a would-be killer.
Oh, me?
You.
Well, thank you. I mean, well, I'm flattered. I don't know why you would ask. Does this have anything to do with Anna's trial?
It could affect the entire outcome. You game?
What would I have to do?